சரக்கு மற்றும் சேவை வரி விதிப்பு தொடர்பான ஜிஎஸ்டி வரி விதிப்புக்கு ஆயத்தமாவோம் என்ற தலைப்பிலான கருத்தரங்கம் சென்னை எழும்பூரில் நடைபெற்றது. செலவு கணக்காளர் அமைப்பின் தென்மண்டல தலைவர் வி முரளி ஏற்பாட்டில் நடைபெற்ற இக்கருத்தரங்கில் மத்திய நிதித்துறை மற்றும் நிறுவனங்கள் விவகார இணையமைச்சர் அர்ஜுன் ராவ் மெவால் சிறப்பு விருந்தினராக கலந்து கொண்டு ஜிஎஸ்டி வரி விதிப்பில் சிறப்பு அம்சங்கள் குறித்து உரையாற்றினார்.
Tell me, GST should come or not? It should come, na?
It should come.
Anybody is against GST in this house? Are you knowing then which country GST has been implemented in the world?
France.
The France is the first country. How many country have implemented the GST?
165,
exactly right. Thank you very much. 165 country have implemented GST. तो क्या भारत अलग रह जाएगा क्या? GST आएगा. And it is the biggest reform in economic sector or in the Indian economy. Or in the economic system of India after independence. There is no doubt about it. But we have some apprehension. You also have some apprehension, I think. In media we have seen some apprehension from the society, from the industry side, and from the technical expert side also. That is why the government has assigned the duty to the Institute of Chartered Accountant, the Institute of Company Secretary, and the Institute of Cost Account Management to organize a seminar in the various places of the country along with CII, ASSOCHAM, PST Chamber and Commerce, FICCI, regional chambers, and respective industrial association of the states. And you are doing also. In that connection, you have organized such particular seminar. I thank you very much for CMA Institute. The area which you also know, I think the 4 or 5 area where the people have apprehension. One is the penalty clause, okay? In Act, we want that this should be done, this should be done. If somebody will not do, what happened? There must be some penal provision, but in this GST cases, we ignore bona fide mistake, but we will not ignore malafide mistakes. Initially we can take a lenient view, but ultimately you have to come in the system. Agreed or not?
Agreed.
Ultimately you have to come in the system, because we want to increase the tax need, we want to increase the tax base. Because still, in the rural area or in the urban area also, we need so many infrastructure facilities are to be created. That is why the tax net is to be increased. One is the penal provision. Second area is the, I think, section 140 within bracket 3,
yes,
anti-profiting clause. If you have any suggestion regarding this, you can tell me. And you can give in the writing also. And you can mail me also. No problem. But we have added in the GST Act anti-profiteering clause. It is also debatable issue, but it was a necessary. That is why we have added in the context of the Indian economy. The other area, I think you must having some confusion, or the industry people have some confusion regarding the reverse charges. That is also an area where you have to think, you have to introspect what should be done. And the other area, in the next other area, is the ITC area, input tax credit area. Okay, these are the area, I think, in which the we have to take a fine tuning, you can say. I can assure you that in the next GST meeting, whatever the representation we are receiving from the industry side, whether from the textile side or whether from the automobile sector, some representation we have received in Tamil Nadu, in Chennai also, regarding the rate on the notebook, such type of representation we are receiving. And in the next GST Council, definitely we will have a agenda for the review of the items. But the final decision will be taken by a GST Council. GST Council is the supreme body in the GST, headed by the finance minister, and every finance minister of the state is also member of the GST Council. And we are taking the decision on the consensus. We are not going on voting. Still, we have not used the voting power in the GST Council. You can raise the issue regarding the composite scheme also. We have a threshold limit up to 20 lakhs and 10 lakhs in the northeast and hilly state. And we have a composition scheme. In that particular composition scheme, we have got some representation that limits should be raised. Initially, we capped 50 lakhs, but in the next GST Council, we raised from 50 to 75 lakhs. If you have any suggestion regarding this composition scheme, if you want that there must be some interstate business should be allowed, or some ITC system, like that, any input you want to give, you can give in writing. You can send me by mail also, no problem. In the next meeting, we will discuss all the issue, no problem. Government is open to discuss all the issue relating to the GST, because it is the biggest reform, it is a new law, and we have to implement it from the 1st July. So it is necessary also to sensitize the provision of the GST to the public. We are giving ad in the newspaper. We are giving ad in the print media and electronic media also. Even that, you are a technical body. Cost Accountant Institute is a technical body, and you all are technical expert also. Any suggestion regarding GST, you can mail me. You can mail Finance Minister. You can mail Revenue Secretary Mr. Adia. We will collect all these ideas, put together in agenda and we will discuss with the state minister in the GST council. Whatever will be the benefit of the country will be in the ease of doing process, definitely we will think positively on this direction. In the next GST meeting, we have reduced in the 66 item, you have seen in the paper, we have reduced in the 66 item. It means government is open again. Whatever the suggestion is necessary, we will definitely accept. We are not adamant. We are not adamant in this connection. Now, you can take one example. What will be the relief of the traders? It is an instrument of the ease of doing business. Suppose one truck starts from Jammu for Chennai. Now, the trucks take 6 days. You can take the average. The trucks take 6 days under the logistic charges. What is the logistic charges? Logistic charges, the transportation charges and the warehouse charges. In India, what is the percentage of the logistic charges? 13.5. And what is the percentage in the developed charges, developed countries? Only 8%. There is a big gap in the logistic charges also. After GST, logistic charges will be the reduced. If trucks start from Jammu for Chennai, now it takes 6 days. After GST, it will take 3 days only. Whether it is beneficial for the Jammu and Kashmir or not, tell me. Whether it is a beneficial for the Jammu and Kashmir transporter or not. In true sense, GST is a one nation, one tax. In true sense. One nation, one tax, one market. We have a different rate. But tax is the only one. We have adopted, as per the circumstances of the India. India is a plural society, vast country. We have a different, you can say, the trade practice. That is why we have adopted exempted GST, means agriculture produce, fruit produce, exempted GST. Then we have a slab of 5%, then 12%, then 18%, then 28%. And then we have a sin product and a bad product and product against the environmental issues. You can say the tambaku, bidi, like that. Where is the sachet is over 28% also. It's a very good, I think, the act. Again, I want to thank Murali ji and his team to organize such a very good seminar on GST. It's a very relevant subject of the today's context in the Indian economy. And again, I want to thank you, CMA. Thank you very much.
Is there anything that the government is doing to address this, or can it be manual for certain period?
We have taken OFC cable issue in a big way, optical fiber cable issue in a big way in the country. And in every Gram Panchayat Mukhyalaya, we have a Atal Seva Kendra, where we have connected all the Atal Seva Kendra through this OFC cable. Broadband connection is available. Wi-Fi facility we are going to provide. In any case, in any part of the country, if it is not possible, then we will create a GST Suvidha Kendra. If any rural entrepreneur, any rural trader wants to fill up a return, he can go to the GST Suvidha Kendra or Atal Seva Kendra
and he can file a return there.
Sir, how many such centers would you open, sir? This GST
suvidha wherever it is necessary.
Okay. For now, any outlook on the number?
In the northeast, we will open wherever it is necessary.
Many
people are, I think, know the English, no?
Yes, sir. I wouldn't say that. So there are so many people who are...
English is the language of the internet.
Okay. But there's so far nothing on board for bilingual entry of data.
For sensitizing this issue, bilingual material we are creating. But for the this broadband and internet, first we will implement it. Then we will see what problem we are facing. Definitely we are open. Whatever the deficiency we feel, we will definitely overcome.
Sir, what about the handloom industry, sir? Many people from the handloom industry who employ very small and, like, you know, unregistered vendors, now today they will have to take the reverse charge if they were to continue employing small scale entrepreneurs, like, you know, like this SHG self-help group.
The small entrepreneur, they are, if they are under the threshold limit, they are exempted from the GST. If they are up to 75 lakhs, they can come under the composition scheme. There are so many options available for the small trader also.
நீங்கள் என்ன அறிந்து கொள்ள விரும்புகிறீர்கள் என்ற தலைப்பில் சென்னை உயர்நீதிமன்ற வழக்கறிஞர் கே வைத்தீஸ்வரன் எடுத்துரைத்தார்.
There is a big movement from existing taxes to GST. And why do we need to transit from existing taxes to GST? The reasons are obvious. If you look at the central government indirect tax structure, highly complex. There is a central excise duty, there is a countervailing duty, there is a special additional duty, then there is product specific cess, coffee cess, rubber cess, tea cess, tractor cess, automotive cess, till 1417 research and development cess, sugar cess, rubber cess, you know, kind of cess. Each cess has got a different act, each cess has got a different rule. You have different dates for compliance, so massive set of compliance. A lot of people ask this question. Sir, there is a 28% GST on this item. Yes. What were you paying before? Sir, earlier, you saw the VAT invoice. In that VAT invoice, you saw only 14.5. There was an excise duty sitting in that costing, which was a 12.5. Costing, pati pesama, cost account, seminar, pesa mudima. So costing has to be brought in. So there is a 12.5 excise duty which is already sitting into the product, and therefore when you look at the invoice, you see only 14.5, whereas there is a 12.5 already sitting. If you look at numbers, 100 plus 12.5, 112.5, then 14.5, effective rate 28. So you are already paying 28. So it is not as if it suddenly become 28. In fact, that is the largest which the government would have done. They could have taken a call and even brought down significantly. Then prices would have really plummeted down. But unfortunately, they sort of match those numbers. So if excise duty is 6, 100 plus 6, VAT is 5. So if you add that, it's about 11.6. So that, they make it 12. So it goes into 12% GST. So like that, they have tried the fitment of rate. So you have to communicate to the public saying, நீ ஏற்கனவே கட்டின டாக்ஸ் தான் பா, ரெண்டு பேர்ல கட்டினது, ரெண்டு ஆளு கட்டினது, இப்போ ரெண்டு ஆளு கட்ட போறான் ஒரு டாக்ஸ் தான். சோ யூ நோ தட் தட் இஸ் தி கைண்ட் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் யூ நீட் டு ஸ்ப்ரெட் அக்ராஸ். சோ தேர் ஆர் மல்டிபிள் டாக்ஸஸ் பட் ஆல் தீஸ் செசஸ் எக்ஸெட்ரா வில் கோ. Now, why did we have this complex system of taxation? The law became complex because of its own nature in the constitution. There was an entry which says you have the power to levy excise duty on manufacture. So therefore, central government levied excise duty. So I manufacture this particular article. When I manufacture this particular article and I clear it, I pay excise duty. But how do I clear it? I sell it locally. Therefore, that sale aspect, local selling aspect attracts VAT. Same item, but that was manufactured, this is sale. Then the same item I decide to sell to Karnataka, then it becomes interstate sale. Interstate sale aspect attracts CST. Because it went to Karnataka, Karnataka fellow says, your product has entered into my state, pay entry tax. So the entry aspect attracts entry tax. Then this becomes defective, I repair it. The repair aspect attracts service tax. In all these activities, if I make profit, profit aspect attracts income tax. So it is nothing but vaalkai ella or vadivathila ponna aspect.
okay, where every aspect is taxed in different form in our country. VAT came in 2005. Each state had their power to levy taxes, each state had their own compulsions. So, for example, gold. Rest of the country, gold was taxed at 1%. Kerala said we'll put a higher rate. You can't stop Kerala because it's their sovereign power to levy tax. Rest of the states, Indus Olympus was at 4%. Pondicherry said I'll put 1%. So, commodity wise, state wise, there were different rates. And if you are a businessman operating throughout the country, you have to know different rates, you have to know different acts, you have to watch different budgets, you must know different notifications, you must be a master in all languages. So, this is VAT. So, you have complex excise system, you have a complex VAT system, and you also have a complex CST system. I'll give you an example as to what is complexity in CST. How many of you are familiar with the word CFOM? How many of you hate the word CFOM? Nobody likes it. Nobody wants CFOM. They want CFOM to go. Well, CST goes, CFOM goes. GST's biggest positive feature is the getting rid of CFOMs. Because you are supposed to collect the CFOMs. Only if you collect the CFOMs, you are entitled to concessional rate of tax of 2%. But you have made an interstate sale. You need the CFOM. It is not coming. That is the big challenge. Now, when VAT came in 2007, I am sitting in Tamil Nadu. I have a customer in Gujarat. I can sell CST sales to him. But when he buys, it is CST purchase, he cannot get the credit because that money has come to Tamil Nadu. Therefore, he tells me, I don't want to buy from you. Arey yaar, I have been supplying for the last 35 years. Doesn't matter, I won't buy from you. So I said, what is the problem? I'm not getting credit. Okay, that is your problem. I'll open a depot in Gujarat. So the Tamil Nadu manufacturer, who had no business plans to go to Gujarat, opens a depot in Gujarat, stock transfers materials from Tamil Nadu to Gujarat, and then invoices locally as GVAT and ensures that his business is on. Which means we have created depots, stock points, godowns, etc. for non-business reasons. So immediately if you say in GST, you can directly supply to anybody. That fellow can get credit. Then I don't need the depot. I don't need the CNTF. I will review my entire business chain. Therefore, a lot of restructuring of business will happen because of CST. Now, how does GST actually pan out? In Tamil Nadu, if you make a supply, a local supply or an intra supply, on that consideration, you pay central government one tax, you pay state government one tax, CGST, SGST. So, when they say GST rate is 18, it has to be split into two, and CGST would be 9 and SGST would be 9 is our assumption. Of course, finally, GO would come, but that's how it will be. So, if the rate is 28, it will be 14 and 14. Whereas, if you do an interstate transaction or an interstate supply, it would be one full rate. It would be 18 or 28 as the case may be. India is implementing GST using fully technology. Everything is digital. Your registration is online. Your filing is online. Your payment is online. Your refund is also online. Which means, in a way, this can arrest corruption. The more and more you say that everything is system oriented, everything is tech oriented, everything is online oriented, and you don't have to interact with anybody, then it gives a relief to some extent to business if it works. If it really works, then this can be really a big change, big ticket change. But the question is, are we technology so savvy? We are making a leapfrog effort. This is what is called as leapfrog. You are jumping from traditional document to suddenly digital compliance. And what are we talking about? Multinationals, yes. Major corporate, yes. Major business, yes. They will all be ready. Traders, dealers, entrepreneurs, firms, HOs, service providers, jewelers, artisans, caterers, contractors, parlors, consultants, job workers, maintenance, transporters, cargo handlers, warehouse keepers, housekeeping, okay, gardening. These kind of small service providers, how can you expect them to be digitally ready? Sir, WhatsApp use padra. WhatsApp phone GST compliance onnu kedaiyadhu. Sir, he is booking film ticket through online. Make my booking he is using. That is super sadhana transaction. So it is going to be a challenge. But surprisingly, different generation look at it differently. Somebody who is very young will say, I'm okay, I'm game, I'll implement this. Somebody who is not very comfortable with technology will say, I don't know what to do. No, it all depends on your outlook. Whether you are ready to embrace the change or you are going to stand and watch the change go by. States and center are talking to each other and they are talking in the same language. All the states have sat together for 17 GST council meetings and all decisions have been unanimous. ஒரு ஃபிளாட் அசோசியேஷன் மீட்டிங்லயே அந்த யுனானிமஸ் வர மாட்டேங்குது. இருக்கிறது ஆறு ஃபிளாட், அதுல ஆறு எக்ஸ் பிரசிடென்ட். Because the current president says I'm not a president still. So you're not able to get any kind of a resolution passed. You're not able to see eye to eye with six people in the same flats. 29 state finance ministers and one center have sat together and decided. Even though it is revenue, they've still decided and they've sat on the same thing. It's a phenomenal achievement for a country like us.